You must keep going. If you can't fly, run. If you can't run, walk. If you can't walk, crawl. But by all means, keep moving.
It's about our children's future, and they are demanding us to find the ways that the climate change will be solved. So this is our task today.
Behind me, there are six experts. They saw data computer database coming in on screen, and they see the pictures in the screen. They said there's a problem.
And especially for women, you know, like when this happened, and I happened to meet a lot of women and everything, I realized that we're very hesitant to take on responsibility. And we're very hesitant to take on new opportunities and things which are new or things which would have been done.
कुछ भी करना चाहूँ, एक्सप्रेस करना चाहूँ, तो दुनिया की कोई ताकत मुझे रोक नहीं सकती है.
All these videos have one thing in common. They all have stories in them. Compelling, persuasive, relatable stories. Welcome to MindBee, my name is Ashutosh, and in today's video, we are going to talk about stories. Before we begin, if you're new here, subscribe and give this video a like. Storytelling is something that we all do. That's how we communicate, bond and evolve. But why we tell stories? To understand this, we have to go back tens of thousands of years when the convoluted organ in our skull was in its evolutionary phase. When we were living together in large hunter and gatherer times, life was precarious and we had to focus on survival, for which we had to work in groups, which sometimes resulted in conflicts. And how you control the group of evolving brains, tribe of evolving brains, is through gossip. Gossip contained valuable information back in the day that actually kept us alive. Tales of hunting, dangers and tool making were passed from one generation to the other. In his book, Sapiens, author Yuval Noah Harari mentions about 100,000 years ago, when Homo sapiens and Neanderthals existed together, Homo sapiens migrated to Africa but came back after losing to Neanderthals. About 70,000 years later, they tried again, and this time they succeeded due to invention of language which allowed them to communicate well. Cognitive evolution allowed Homo sapiens to dominate the earth and survive. Some evolutionary psychologists argue that language evolved for gossip. That's how I think the oral tradition of storytelling to pass knowledge and human to human experience evolved. Few stories travel from one village to the other, few travel from nations to nations. These stories shaped us how we think about ourselves and about others. Like old scriptures, Puran, Upanishad, Ved in Indian scripture, even the religious scripts have stories in them with a cause and effect relationship, setting a belief system for a community following it. So our brains are so hardwired to process and store information in the form of stories that even in today's world, believe it or not, we consume so much information through stories. Fundraising for a non-profit or an NGO, stories. Want to educate, stories. Want to entertain, stories. Branding and advertising, stories. Pitching an idea or making a presentation, stories. So we humans are creatures that live on narratives, entertained by the stories we hear and directed by the stories we believe about ourselves and about the world. So when next time you are at a networking event or in the middle of career transition, or you're just traveling and you meet bunch of new people, don't forget to use the power of stories. Thank you for watching this video, and do tell us in comments how storytelling helped you.